Hey everybody, it's Angeline here. I know it's been some time since I made my last video, but here I'm back again with a fresh new video and some gelatos to show you today. I know I've shown these before, but these are the double scoop gelatos. And if you look at the original size, let me get some here, it's actually really double the size, so you get much more for money. And last week we were having this haul with Unity Stamps and Faber-Castell, and most of you left wonderful comments for me. Thank you very much. And if you're interested to see that post, you can click right here. And there were three techniques I was showing using the gelatos, and I thought I'd show you another one today. So let's get started. Okay, for the supplies, you'd need some embossing powder. Here I'm using the Pearl Silver, I think it's by Ranger. Some embossing ink, I'm using Versamark. Some black ink, I'm using Memento Tuxedo Black. Some stamps, gelatos of course. This is the embossing powder to prep your surface. You could use baby powder if you want. Washi tape and water and some watercolor cardstock and some white cardstock. The list of the supplies will be listed below, so don't worry if you can't catch any of that. And let's begin. Okay, so today I'm going to make a Christmas card, and I'm gonna stamp a sentiment right here, and I'm gonna mask it off, and then we will emboss the snowflakes right around it. Okay, so first up, you're gonna use some black ink or any ink that you like. Okay. Ink it up real good and stamp it right in the middle. I'm just gonna eyeball it. You could measure if you want. And after that, I'm just going to use a scrap piece of paper. I'm just going to mask it off with some washi tape. And just a little bit right here, just to make sure the card sticks in its place. So before you start inking up your stamps for the embossing part, get the powder tool and just prep your surface. This is just to make sure that there's no static when you place your embossing powder, and it will actually only emboss at the right places. Okay. Get done. Get your stem and emboss it with some embossing ink. And we're gonna place some embossing powder on it. This technique I've actually learned from Jennifer McGuire, so it's a good technique not to mess up your entire craft area when you place embossing powder. Just tap off the excess and make sure you got every part of it. And you're done. So if you saw any parts that, like, you know, caught the unwanted embossing powder, just get a dry brush and just brush it off. Right. Okay, so I'm gonna run my heat tool over this and I'll be right back. Okay, so I'm back, and if you can see the silver embossing
Right? So right now,
we're gonna mask it back on with your scrap paper just now. There. And now we're gonna use some gelatos. Here I'm using the raspberry and guava. It's a very nice shade of pink and purple. And why we are using watercolor cutsalt is because we're gonna use a lot of water on this. So let's just start off by placing some random coloring some random spots around. Okay. It doesn't look like anything pretty right now, but you'll see afterwards. Okay. So once you're done with that, and just spritz some water. I'm just gonna do the top part first, just in case it dries out, because the weather here is pretty humid. And if you do not want to contain your colors, I'm just gonna wipe your finger off on a rag cloth or a paper towel, okay? And more water down there. Okay. And after this, you're just gonna get a paper towel and or a red cloth and just dry it up.
Okay, so now we're back and I've dried this up, and to get back the silver, the shine in it, you just have to use a baby wipe or a towel. Just when it's wet, just rub over it and you'll see the embossed parts again. So this, you're gonna get like a watercolor effect on this. And before I mount this here, just gonna do like a border around the card, and you could just swipe it across the card like that. So if you want, you could use your fingers again just to slightly blend it in. Okay, so now I've actually mounted the piece onto a white cardstock, and I'm gonna finish it up by just adding this star blings on it just to add some interest. Okay, so I think that's all right. And we're done. So this is the final card. I hope you like this technique, and do subscribe if you like my videos, and I'll see you again. Bye. If you like today's video, click the thumbs up. And if you're not a subscriber already, don't forget to hit the subscribe button now. If you'd like more details on this card, feel free to visit my blog at scrappyscrappy.blogspot.com. And to keep updated on the social media, like my Facebook page and follow me on Pinterest.